Really thrilling stories have developed up there.
I know, some of them involving you guys.
Well, you put us on to that helicopter job.
Nice to be out here. Is this the way you live down here?
This is the kind of comfort we live in. I just had my first sip of soup since breakfast. It's tough down here. Yeah. Why don't we review, however, some of these alpine skiing events, Frank?
Well, let's do that. First of all, as I said, in the men's downhill, there's an incredible story of a young Austrian who came over, and Bob and I had watched him over developing. He was hurt earlier in the year, Leonardo Stock.
Okay, here he comes.
Let's take a look at it. First, here is our home away from home. They had some really great weather for us up there, didn't they, Bob? We had everything from Miami to Anchorage, Alaska. You'd get it every 3 or 4 minutes. That's the weather station, of course, on the summit. And all the alpine events took place right here.
You notice, Jim, there aren't a lot of trees on the top of that mountain. For a good reason. The wind blows a lot.
That's right.
I think for the ladies downhill, the chill factor in the morning, we couldn't believe it, but it was 71 below zero was their report.
The music, of course. I love New York.
And certainly Leonard Stock of Austria did. He wasn't expected to even ski in the downhill, right, Bob? And he just skied somebody else off the team, and this was the result.
You know, this really was a great performance. He turned so well, and he came from nowhere. Wasn't even going to be on the team. It's kind of a, you know, it's a really great story in alpine skiing.
And we clocked the fastest racer, and it wasn't Stock, but the fastest racer in this downhill was going 89 miles per hour. Leonard Stock finishing first, Peter Wernsberger, as the Austrians picked up a double there. And Steve Podborski of Canada got in there for third. Not bad for the North Americans.
Austrians were a good nomination for prettiest uniforms this year, I think, too.
And they really broke it out, didn't they?
Yeah.
They got themselves a new designer. They did all right. Won two in the downhill.
Boy, did they have good reason to love New York.
And coming up, the day that we spoke of, and it was so cold, Anna Marie Moser, 12. Bob has followed her for career for so many years. She's done everything to win a gold medal. She'd won just everything there was to do in World Cup, and she put on a show this day, didn't she, Bob?
Well, the thing that was so great about her, really, was that the pressure was on. She was, you know, she's never been able to win a gold medal in the Olympics, as Frank has mentioned, but she was really not the favorite in this event. But boy, I'll tell you, when it counted, she was there.
And, of course, it was back in 72, and she was so favored. Bob does the downhill and the giant slalom that was taken away by Marie-Therese Nottie, who got the bronze, by the way. She was favored. And, of course, it was Honey Wenzel who really began the big story of the mountain. As she, well, she did match the exploits of Rosie Mittermeier in 76, but, of course, we didn't know it at this point. Again, our chilly home.
Rosie won the two golds first and then the silver, whereas Honey won the silver. And
Honey started out with the silver, so it didn't have the drama that we had. And then how about this man? He is just absolutely special. We had a song at the beginning of the Olympics that said, nobody does it better, and I think you probably have to agree, nobody has ever done it quite like this.
You know, it's pretty amazing. You're the favorite, you come into the event, but you've never won an Olympic gold medal, same as Rose, as Prell, and look at him. I mean, he was unbelievable.
And another little Liechtenstein story continued. Honey Wenzel, of course, of Liechtenstein. There is the leader, of course. Andras Wenzel took the silver there, and Hans Inn of Austria took a bronze. In the women's giant slalom, and here she is again. Had this all been reversed, Jim would have been talking about it throughout the Olympics, just as we did Rosie Mittermeier over
right.
in Austria.
Well, you know, it's amazing that Liechtenstein comes out as the alpine power of these Olympics. They got two gold and two silver.
The
Austria
family.
Had two gold, one silver, and one bronze.
Yeah, let's put it this way. It's the family that came out.
The family Wenzel.
The Wenzel family.
As we said one day up there, you could put the entire population of Liechtenstein in Madison Square Garden.
What is it, 14 miles by 8, 20,000 people?
8 miles across, and there they are. Irene, as we said, the...
Epler's on the left.
Epler's on the left, and Pauline of France on the right. The women's giant slalom.
The appealing group of young women. Epler, a smart, intelligent, nice young lady.
Well, she is, too. Skis well.
Yes, in addition.
I guess you can ski well and still live in the mountains.
So this really was your home away from home.
It was, and I must say, the people who were in charge of conditioning this hill, they just did a magnificent job. And our engineers, we had well over 100 of them up there for so long. As we look at Stenmark again in the slalom, which he doubled up on his goal, everyone just did a fabulous job up there.
You know, Ray Prater used to be a history teacher at Lake Placid High. He was head of all the sports here, and they were all run perfectly.
Now, they did a great job. You know, a lot of the officials were there for about a month, all volunteers. I mean, they really were.
Sergei Lucy was running the Alpine, right?
Right.
And here's Stenmark again through the slalom. And, of course, it was here that the Americans got their top finish right behind Stenmark. Phil Mayer led after the first run. And I'll tell you, it really created an electric atmosphere up there. We're going to take a look at his silver medal run. Phil Mayer, who, as we all know, had that tremendous accident here less than a year ago and had the seven screws in the ankle and the metal plate. No one thought he'd race again. And it just built to this incredible drama. And of course, he couldn't pull it off against maybe the greatest racer of all time, but he did get the silver.
Well, if you got to be second, Stenbock's not a bad guy to be second.
Indeed, it isn't. So that was Phil Mayer and Jacques Clouty winning the silver, rather the bronze. And then we had the ladies' slalom. And here was, well, Bob, I think you characterized it as maybe the finest run of slalom you've ever seen.
You know, it really was. This girl is so good technically. It's just unbelievable the way she skis. She's so controlled. She does everything in her life that way, but she really does ski well.
We watch her come down, I'll tell you too, that Heidi Preuss of the United States, a youngster, got a fourth in the women's downhill. Cindy Nelson got a seventh. Pete Patterson had a fifth in the men's downhill. And we had Phil Mayer, of course, with the silver. Kristen Cooper got a seventh in the ladies' GS. And, of course, Phil Mayer did his thing in the giant slalom, getting a tenth. So we didn't do that all that badly. And, you know, we just think we should win all the time, Jim. But we've got some young kids that are coming.
We first ran into Bob Viatti 16 years ago. He's the coach of the national ski team. Now he's not only our expert commentator on ski racing, but many other sports, volleyball, weightlifting, to say nothing of Mr. Universe. And as for you, Frank Gifford, one-time idol of the gridiron, just a great job. That's all I can say.
Thank you, Jim. I don't think there's any happening quite like the Olympics. And just
this is a great
pleasure to be here again.
Okay. Well, in just about a minute, we're going to be right back here again. And the next subject will be speed skating, a rather popular subject, you might say, at these Winter Olympic Games in Lake Placid. So hang in there. We have a long way to go, but it's going to be fun.
You've come to the roof of the world, where no man has skied before. Blazing a trail through virgin snow, going for all the gusto you can get, and you go for it. In your life, in your beer. Schlitz, the one beer brewed with gusto since 1849. The official beer of the Winter Olympics. Go for it.
Well, you've just sold me on a great typewriter, but I work with numbers.
The Lanier No Problem typewriter does more than just type. Financial typing, no problem. It even adds and subtracts.
I do our personnel list. Will it help there?
No problem. It sorts alphabetically and numerically and gets your work back faster.